one person might see this. Okay. Because wherever two or more gathered, one person, uno mas, one. In my experience, one-to-one interactions are key. They are the key. They are the water to the seed. Marching is great. We've been doing it forever, right? But again, what are you doing after the marching and the protesting and the complaining and the bitching and the fighting and the yelling and the screaming? You know what? I love Trump. I dare you to love him. Love him. Because him coming into office inspired people to take action beyond the marching. I've been loving him the whole time. I'm not going to get into politics. I love all two-legged, four-legged, winged ones and crawlers, and it's not easy to love thy neighbor who plays their instrument out of tune, is it? So this is my work. So I'm going to say this, I'm going to share it, take what you want, and leave the rest. The ego is a problem only because we as a human being have lost our connection with God. Say it, I dare you. You can say creator, goddess, universe, mother nature. It's God. It's God. I'm remembering I walked away from my conscious contact with God. Those of us looking outside of ourselves to find purpose, to make change, we blame. We reflect through each other. Sure, we do. Until we see deep within ourselves. So the reflections of others on this road home is very important. So give other people a break. Let them be. If it is true that we are healed through others, then isn't it true? It's because we were open to receive the healing that God uses to move through all of us. I do this for years. I do it myself. I see a lot of people do it. And then I come upon my equal, who doesn't claim to be a healer. I'm connected to the mainstream world and I'm connected to the already practicing medicine world. Spiritual bypassing, speaking of spiritual language, talking of love, and then treating your neighbor like shit. I mean, ego. Edging God out. Ego. For me. My ego reacts. For my soul, it's because I've lost my connection to breath, to the thread. Remember where I came from, to remember before the womb, before my mother's womb. Who do you think, what do you think put you in the world? Oh, I used to smell death for years. I smelled the stench of rotting flesh. No one else smelled it but me. I could have hung a shingle right there and then. The healer who can smell death. I'm going to heal you from your death. Then, as I went deeper into my ancestral roots, to free the souls of our ancestors that are trapped in the genetic coding within our lineage. Some people have visions of what to build outside of themselves and make money and create and build and climb. Well, my path goes deeper and deeper and deeper into a world where all of the souls are trapped and our ancestors are trapped, and it is us to us to free. Ancestors that are trapped inside our genetic coding. That's where the depression is coming from. If you haven't heard about it yet, it's been scientifically proved that our ancestors that were depressed because we're feeling the depression of our ancestors. There has to come a point where you stop blaming others. There has to come a point of awakening, which is now, and we will not all awaken. My mother thinks I'm crazy. I died in my mother's womb. What you think of me is none of my business. I'm connected to God, and I am protected. Nothing that any human being will say or do will have any effect on my wall. I am here to serve God because I have prayed to remember before the womb and my prayers have been answered. Many have tried to tame me. Most healers, facilitators, teachers, guides, shamans, the humans with the big fucking egos that claim to be connected, but yet they are not, because they are not trusting breath. Who do you think's breathing you? Who do you think is pumping your blood? I'm not talking about man or woman. Several short sessions a day are much more valuable than one long session. When we all come together and we all just stop for 10 minutes a day, 5 times a day, once a day, just put your hands on the earth, say thank you, just breathe and worship God, your God, whatever your version of God is, because it's you. It is you, 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 you. Blah, 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 blah.